Okay, so I'm going to try to describe my workflow for using the DA Star 300 on the queue. So right now we've got the DA Star 300 with the Pentax K adapter. I've got it set for setting 1, which gives me 5.6 f-stop on the DA Star 300. I'm going to go ahead and turn on the camera. When you first turn the camera on in this mode, it comes up with the input focal length screen. It's already at 300, so that's good. That's what I want, because I'm using the DA Star 300. Now, the next thing you see is, on the screen, you see that I'm in manual mode. I've got the 2-second timer set, and manual focus is defaulted because I'm using the adapter. You also notice that the exposure value scale is shown that I'm a little bit underexposed. And that's generally what I want, because the queue tends to overexpose a little bit, and it'll also blow out highlights, for example, if you're shooting a white bird or something. I mean, if it's not where I want it to be, the exposure, I'll use the wheel, which will change my shutter speed and will move my exposure point to the left or to the right, depending on what I set. So as I mentioned, I normally like to run around between a half minus or one minus exposure value. So right now it's showing, since I'm indoors, 0.4 seconds. And the ISO is also set for 125. I want to make sure that my ISO value is as low as possible, and since I'm in manual, I want to set that at 125, which is the base ISO for the queue. Next thing I would do is to focus on the object. In this case, I have a door jamb over there that I'm looking at, and I'll turn the focus knob, try to get that in focus. I do have focus peaking on, so it helps a little bit. If I need a little bit more assistance, what I'll do is hit the OK button, which you should see here now. Hit the OK button, and that it magnifies the image. And then I can, again, play with the focus a little bit, get it where I want. And then once it's set, and then I can go ahead and hit the shutter. When I press the shutter, just halfway, it sets it back over to the standard view on the LCD. Then I click it to take the shot, and then it goes ahead and takes the shot.